First of all, your reaction to this whole Todd Akin fiasco. What do you make of it, and what does it mean for the presidential battle?
Well, obviously, what he said is despicable and outrageous, and it's good at least to see his own party trying to banish him from the race. But the fact that he is not dropping out, the fact that he co-sponsored legislation, you know, related to this issue with Congressman Ryan, I think is going to be a real ball and chain for the Romney-Ryan ticket with women and men in this country. So I think it's something, it's clear they're trying to get him out of the race because that will obviously diffuse it for the moment. But if they can't, and it looks like he won't leave, it's going to be, I think, a real problem for them with women in particular, but with men as well.
But that is a big problem if it's with women, because women are going to be one of the main battlegrounds of this election. I mean, President Obama, you know, has a better percentage of women in America who like him over Mitt Romney. This is not going to close that gap. This is going to probably widen it. The more focused the Democrats, and you could see by President Obama's press conference yesterday, the more that he can get the agenda onto social conservative issues like this, then I would imagine the more he thinks he will increase and widen the gap for the female vote.
Well, you know, I think that's all exactly right, Piers. I would simply add that, you know, if we're going to have an election campaign about abortion, we're not going to have an election campaign about education, infrastructure, immigration, debt deficit and entitlement.